Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav from Automation Step by Step. And in this session and in this series, we are going to learn TypeScript from scratch from the very basics. So this is for complete beginners and I will teach you TypeScript step by step from scratch. And do not worry if you have no prior experience with programming or with TypeScript. I will show you all the demos and the examples and you can follow along me with hands-on. So let's get started and first let us see what is TypeScript. So TypeScript is an open source programming language from Microsoft and it is a superset of JavaScript. So it is not a completely new programming language. It extends JavaScript by adding some features and some functionalities that we are going to learn. So TypeScript extends JavaScript by adding types. Let me show you this. I will go to my editor. Now do not worry, I'm going to show you all this environment setup and IDE in the coming sessions. But just for now, to show you a very, very basic difference, I'm going to create a JavaScript file and I will name this as basic.js. So I just created a JavaScript file with the extension .js. And here I'm going to create a variable and in JavaScript we use where. And I will say x equals 10. So I have created a variable x and I have given the value 10, which is a numerical value. Now if I say x equals and I give another value, which is a string value, and you can see there is no error. So there is no issue here. I can still do this. But suppose if this is TypeScript, let me create a new file and this I will call as basic.ts. So ts is the extension for TypeScript. And now if I just copy the same code here, I will copy this and put it in my TypeScript file here. And here you can see I have got a red line here under x. So if I hover over it, it says type string is not assignable to type number. So do you see TypeScript has types and that is how it adds the types to JavaScript. And this is just the starting. We will see a lot of features. And as I have said, TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript. So it is not a new programming language. And it eventually compiles down to plain JavaScript. And we also say it transpiles down to plain JavaScript because it is not a new language. And if you already have a JavaScript file or a JavaScript code, you can convert it into a TypeScript code. And the advantage is TypeScript validates the JavaScript ahead of time because as you have seen here, it is telling me even without running and before running my code that there is some issue here. In JavaScript, we have dynamic typing, that is the types are resolved at runtime. When I run this code, then it will check if there are any type issues. But in TypeScript, all this is done beforehand. So that is a main advantage of using TypeScript. And now if I say why to use TypeScript, then we have already seen that it is an extended JavaScript. If you are already using JavaScript, then you do not have to learn a new programming language. And even if you have not used JavaScript, still you can use TypeScript and you can work with your JavaScript code. You can just rename a .js or a JavaScript file to a .ts or TypeScript file. There is optional static typing and type inference. So here we have seen this is optional typing. The reason I say optional, this is something we will discover in the coming sessions. And inference means as I have given the value here x equals 10, so it has inferred that x is of type number and therefore it is not allowing any non-numeric value for x. So JavaScript is dynamically typed, that is the types are resolved at runtime, whereas TypeScript is optionally typed and it adds the type support to JavaScript. Errors are identified even before you run your code during the compilation type. It also adds IntelliSense and code completion. And this is because now we know that x is a number. So as I will say x dot, it will give me all the code completion and IntelliSense for the number data type of JavaScript. So therefore, we have a very good support in terms of IntelliSense and code completion, and therefore it makes our code more efficient and less error prone. You can also go to the website for TypeScript. So if I search for TypeScript, you can go here, typescriptlang.org, and this will show you all the details. You can see TypeScript extends JavaScript by adding types, and it saves you a lot of time as it catches all the errors, and it is open source. And here it says TypeScript validates your JavaScript ahead of time. So all this you can see here. And in the coming session, we will start with the environment setup. We will select a IDE and start learning TypeScript. I hope this was very useful for you. If you have liked this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my YouTube channel. I will see you in the next session. Thank you for watching.